Hi there, Dan Munch, one half the Flippin' Info Guys, and another edition of Edmonton Uncovered. We are in the community of Riverdale, and we really are with one of the owners of a hidden gem. This place is a lunch, a brunch, and a coffee shop nestled in the heart of Riverdale, and it really is unique not only to Edmonton, but to Riverdale. Hello, Carmen. Thanks
Hi.
For having us.
Thanks for having me.
That's cool. So, 4 years in, So did you ever think this was going to be such a successful venture for yourself and your...
Never.
No?
Never. Honestly, this was a test for us. Coming into a residential neighborhood, not knowing, are people going to come here during the day? Are hours of operation going to be conducive to the neighborhood? Are people going to ride their bikes here? We were totally uncertain, but it's way exceeded our expectations.
And there's no market research that you can do to say, yeah, we're going to have this much foot traffic, we're going to do this. So it really was a sort of sink or swim type of business.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
you definitely swam.
Thank you.
Yeah, so what does Little Bit Cafe offer?
So we are definitely known for our brunches. We're known for supporting local business. So we've got a general store in our cafe. We sell local items from local artists, local vendors. We also pride ourselves in supporting local farms on our menu.
So what sort of local produce do you get in from these local farms that we have in Alberta?
Our eggs come from Four Whistle Farms.
Okay.
Tomatoes come from there as well. We try to, as much as we can, use local produce, okay. local farmers, yeah. as much as we can anyways.
So your general store, they're all yeah. Alberta, or even local, even more locally sourced.
We try as much as we can to stick Edmonton
okay.
as the main focus. But if it's not from Edmonton, it's definitely from Alberta. And if it's not from Alberta, it's definitely Western Canada. So we keep as local as we can. We've got a few vendors from Vancouver just mixed in there. But we want to make sure that we're supporting Edmonton.
I had a little joke.
Yeah.
The maple syrup is definitely from Canada.
It's definitely from Canada, yes.
And also driving down here, I saw you have a new venture.
And you, right now, our focus, obviously, is fall. But we're leading into Christmas season and people are starting to think about Christmas parties, so our goal is to book as many Christmas parties as we can this
okay.
winter.
Yeah.
It's a great little space if you have a small company from, let's say 20 employees to 45 employees. We book it out exclusively for you and we customize our menus, which we're excited about this year. So.
Yeah. Okay. So also Halloween, what about Halloween? Is there anything going on?
Halloween, well, the neighborhood obviously trick-or-treats, so we'll be open for trick-or-treating,
okay.
giving out
yeah.
candy bars to the kids.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So real community-based.
It is, definitely.
Business.
We would not be here if it wasn't for the residents and the neighbors of okay. Riverdale supporting us. We now have people that come from all over Edmonton, but we definitely, our core customer is definitely the people supporting us that live in Riverdale.
And hence
expanding. It's been so nice, yeah.
And hence expanding into a larger yeah. business just a block away.
We put a lot of effort into our social media. You can follow us on Instagram at littlebrickyeg.
Okay.
We also have a Facebook page, obviously, our website. We do a lot of online sales as well for our general store, which is also on our website.
Okay.
So you can go there.
Awesome. So you heard it here first. Little Brick Cafe is starting up a new venture in Riverdale. If you haven't been to Little Brick Cafe, come here and look out for updates on the new venture just a couple of blocks down in the heart of Riverdale. Speak to you all soon.
Hey, good job.